بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
I always pictured that one day I would be speaking at this summit, and I always promised myself that whenever I got this opportunity, I would raise the first and foremost, the most important question about whenever in the Western countries people blaspheme our Prophet, peace be upon him. I always felt that the response from the Muslim Ummah, the OIC, I always felt it was lacking. The OIC owes a responsibility. Us heads of the states, we have a responsibility to the Muslim world. When anyone in the Western world blasphemes our Prophet, peace be upon him, it is a failure of the OIC that we have not been able to explain to the Western countries that the love and affection that we feel for our Holy Prophet, that how he lives in our hearts. It was up to us to explain to the Western people that the amount of pain they cause us when they ridicule or mock our Holy Prophet. We must, in the forums like the United Nations, forums like the European Union, we must explain to them that they cannot hurt the sentiment of 1.3 billion people under the garb of freedom of expression. The Jewish community has very successfully explained to the world that any misinterpretation of the Holocaust gives them pain. And so the Western world views Holocaust with a lot of sensitivity. But that sensitivity is lacking when they come to talking about our Holy Quran or our Prophet, peace be upon him. So I feel that this forum must take it upon itself to explain to the Western world through these forums what it means to us and how we love and respect our Holy Prophet. Secondly, the Western world has very, through ignorance partly and willfully, they have equated Islam with terrorism, or radical Islam with terrorism. Religion has nothing to do with terrorism. This attack in New Zealand by this gunman who goes into a mosque and shoots 50 innocent people is because they cannot understand that Islam has nothing to do with terrorism. And they have this indoctrination that somehow whenever a Muslim is involved in terrorism, it's something to do with Islam. Before 9/11, 80% of the suicide terrorist attacks were by Tamil Tigers. But no one blamed Hinduism for it. When the Japanese in the Second World War indulged in kamikaze pilots who blew themselves up on American ships, but no one blamed the Japanese religion for it. The heads of Muslim states have not been able to explain to the West, not powerfully enough, that Islam has nothing to do with terrorism. Political struggles have everything to do with terrorism. Muslim freedom struggles or Muslim freedom political struggles are delegitimized when they are termed as because of Islamic radicalism. For instance, after 9/11, the people of Kashmir have been conducting a political struggle for their freedom. But after 9/11, it was oppressed, calling it Islamic radicalism and Islamic terrorism. Similarly, the Palestinians. After 9/11, the Palestinians were oppressed, using the Israeli government, used the word Islamic terrorism. So this is my second point. I feel that from this forum, we must take a stand. We must de-link terrorism with Islam. Finally, Mr. Chairman, I would like to say that this is 50 years of OIC, and we all must again reiterate that how this organization came was because of the Palestinians being deprived of their homes, their rights, the human rights, the democratic rights. And so we reiterate again that there is no solution but a two-state solution in Palestine. East Jerusalem must become the capital of the for the Palestinian people. And the Golan Heights must be returned as the 1967 borders, which all the international conventions, the United Nations resolutions say so. Similarly, I feel that in Kashmir, the people of Kashmir again have not been given their right to self-determination, as was guaranteed by the world community in 1948 through a UN resolution. The people of Kashmir recently have suffered a lot of oppression, and I do feel that us as a body, the OIC, must stand with the oppression that is going on in the Muslim world. I finally want to thank again King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud for his great hospitality. I especially want to thank we had the great opportunity to go into to visit the Rauza Rasul in Medina yesterday, and from me and my delegation we want to say that it gave us the greatest happiness and pleasure to be able to visit the mosque. Thank you very much.